How many of you have been to Costa Rica? Great. So for those of you who have not been to Costa Rica, and after Pilar's presentation, I'm going to try to introduce you some of the things that we're doing. But before doing that, I like to place ourselves where we are at the moment in the challenges that we're facing at the world. Climate change has become the biggest challenge the world is facing. We are literally toward the edge of a cliff. If we continue the way that we're doing, and there is an increase of 1 centigrade, 14% of the world population will be severely affected by heat waves. If we go to 2%, that means that that figure will raise to 37%. If, according to the International Panel for Climate Change, our temperature is increased by 1%, and additionally 350 million city dwellers will face water shortage. If we go to 2%, that means that that number will increase to 411 million people in the world. And let's talk about something that is very pertinent for the Emirates, and it's sea level rise. If we continue with the way that we are, one more centimeter of high temperatures will bring up to 69 million people that will be affected. If we go to 2%, that increases to 80 million. And that's not the only thing that we're causing to the world. Look what we have achieved since 1970 to 2014. We have been able to wipe out 60% of the mammals, of the birds, of the fishes, and the reptile. If we have done that to our own civilization, that will mean 60%. If we go back to our humanity, that will mean that 60% of the population, that will be equivalent if we raise North America, South America, Africa, Europe, China, and Oceania. That's what we have done to the world today. Let's talk about inequalities. Of 143 countries in the world, 90% has one law that prevents equality between women and men. And in only 20 countries in the world do women and men have the same right to own land. But there are also good news. And we have seen, for example, how women now are the world's third largest emerging market in the world. And we make up to 70% of the decisions within the households. And that is extremely important when it comes to climate change. And we have examples all around the world. This is the 1 million women campaign in Australia that have been reducing their impact, their consumption pattern, and it is equivalent of taking 240,000 cars off the roads by just doing things in a different way. Also, climate change is causing that we have new disasters, more severe disasters. From 1970 to 2010, we had the highest major disaster and the strongest disaster reported on the world. The average of people exposed increases by flooding to 114%. And globally physically exposed to tropical cyclones increase by 192%. And that also has a human face. London School of Economics conducted a study of 141 countries, and they found out that in those countries with a higher gender gap, more women than men died. And I'm gonna tell you the story. That's Mitch. Mitch was a hurricane that affected our region. There was a woman in Honduras living by the coast when Mitch attacked, the biggest hurricane that we have had in our region. Her neighbor comes and tells her there are winds of 260 kilometers coming. And her answer was, how much is 260 kilometers? She had never been to school. She had never driven a bicycle. 260 kilometers meant nothing to her. So with her friends, they said, let's start walking by the Stoarium, something that you never do when there is a flood. She had two babies, one tied to her chest, the other two by her hand. The waters came down the mountains and up the seas, and she had to climb a tree and lost the other two babies. She was there for 3 days, brought into a refugee camp, and she said, you know what happens to a single mom? She was raped. And then she went back to a house that was made of cardboard and zinc. There was nothing left. And then an NGO came and said, Doña Vera, do not worry. We're going to rebuild you the house. Do you know the single thing that they asked her for? What will be your guess? Property rights that she didn't have for the land in which her house had been built. And like that, all around the world, this environment, this new way of climate change, this environmental degradation has a differentiated impact. And that impact is for every man that dies in countries in which gender gaps are bigger, 4 women die. That is the proportion according to this School of London, School of Economics. And those that are trying to protect the environment, those that are working on human rights, that is what we're seeing worldwide. In 2014, 160 environmental activists were murdered. In 2015, more than 3 people were killed per week for protecting the basics of human rights when it comes to environmental issue. And in 2017, 217 defenders were killed, and 60% of those in Latin America, where Costa Rica is. So this is the context in which Costa Rica has been trying to lead by the example. Costa Rica has been aware of these inequalities. Costa Rica has been aware of what has been happening to our environment. And that is why, for the past decades, visionaries, women and men, have invested in the wealth, in the environmental wealth of our country. As Pilar was saying, 0.3 territory of the world, but we have 5% of the world's biodiversity. 35%, Pilar said 20, but we have to think that protected areas are not only the ones that the government manage, but also the ones that are in the private hands. We are a country of peace. Since 1948, we have no army, 120 years of political stability, and one of the happiest countries in the world. That's what we are. But we have also invested in our people. So we have the largest women representation in this government with 45.6. Pilar is one of the 13 women in parity in our cabinet. And for every 100 men, there are 187 women with bachelor degrees. And for every 100 men that have masters, 142. And those are numbers that you don't get in 4 years. This has been the legacy, again, of many decades of policies, of vision, and of moving forward. So that example, that leading by example, is what we have taken in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and try to share what we have learned through two of our objectives in our work. One, environment and climate change, and the second one, social inclusion and gender equality. And this leading by example means that this combination of the knowledge, the public policy, the transformation, and sometimes the risks that we have taken in the country had made Costa Rica universally recognized for its innovative solutions. And incredible people. This is one of our national treasures, Cristiana Figueres, whoever was on climate change. She's a Costa Rican. She led the Paris Accord so that we could still try to save the world that we are. And that leading by example has also made us not only known for our forest schemes, it's because we're trying to think outside the box with this new decarbonization of our economy. We're trying to move away from business as usual. We are committed to decrease our emissions while we continue growing. And it doesn't have to do only with electrification of our transport system. It has to do in the way that we produce agriculture. It has to do with reforestation. It has to do with the way that we manage our oceans. So our decarbonization plan is a very economic and environmental plan that it is together. And also, in this leading by example, Costa Rica has been working on mainstreaming gender and human rights, not only in our country, but also we have become warriors, let me say, even though we don't have an army, of trying to take these principles to other parts of the world. One of the things that we're very proud of, and here we have some of our colleagues that work in that, is the Escazú Agreement. Remember that data of the amount of people killed, 60% in Latin America? With the Escazú Agreement, what we're trying to do precisely is to protect the defenders, to understand that the right to nature is a human right, and that those that are defending that environment for the future have the right to be informed and to participate. The Escazú Agreement, Escazú is the name of one of the places that we have in Costa Rica, was led by our country. The other thing that we're doing is the work of making our work in the environmental sector more gender responsive. We have recognized that living outside of the equation 7 billion people, it's illogical. It's illogical to ignore half of the force of the world. Who in its mind will leave this amount of human capital out of the solutions? And this is how we have been able to develop gender frameworks for the major multilateral agreements, environmental agreements. Costa Rica has supported the development of plan of actions of gender on climate change, on biodiversity, on drylands. And we just launched last year the For All Coalition. The For All Coalition, what it's trying to do is those countries that still do not know how to link human rights and gender equality and environment, we are bringing them together and saying, these are possible entry points to do that. And we're doing that from our Ministry of Foreign Affairs. We feel, and now that Felipe is going to talk, that now we have the responsibility of sharing this knowledge. And this alliance with the Emirates is an incredible opportunity for us to really join efforts and sharing what we have done. It's with these alliances, we consider Costa Rica can become this catalyst of change around the world. And we see ourselves as a hope, a hub for hope. And Felipe is gonna talk about the green hub. But in general, Costa Rica can give the world the hope that we are missing. This is a hot spot on innovation that we're trying to share with the world. And I will always remember some of the words that some of the women in the communities that I have worked with can express and said, in addition to the trees, you need to remember that women and men should grow along with. So if I could share with you very fast at the end, what is my country? Our power doesn't reside in our militaries, nor in the size of our nation or our GDP. We're not a huge country. Our power is founded in our long democratic tradition, in our long-standing fight to assure human rights. In our history of living in peace and sharing nature, but especially the value of smile and happiness. And if you have ever heard what pura vida is, pure life, is the expression of all of that. Costa Rica, it's all about pure life, pura vida. Thank you very much, and come and share our dreams with us. Thank you very much.